So, Nancy, nice to meet you. Ned sent you here to check up on me, huh?
Do you mind?
Not really. Ned's a nice guy. I mean, I really don't know him that well, just from school. But when I mentioned that my only living relative just died, he was all like, "Yeah? How you feeling, man? You doing okay? Wanna talk?" Of course, I guess I do come across as a little needy sometimes.
Were you very close to your uncle?
Great uncle. Great uncle Bruno, and no, I wasn't. My parents died in a car crash when I was 8. Since I had no other relatives, he took me in. Or should I say he shipped me out? Boarding school, summer camp, military school, college. He may have looked after me, but he never spent any time with me. I didn't know him at all.
Yet you came all the way down here for the funeral?
Not really. Great Uncle Bruno named me executor of his estate, which means I have to make sure all his bills are paid and debts taken care of so his assets can be distributed. Unfortunately, he couldn't have cared less about little things like keeping records or balancing checkbooks. Dealing with his creditors and their lawyers has been an absolute nightmare. So, thanks for stopping by, Nancy. And now you can report back to Ned that I'm fine and go enjoy New Orleans.
No, I can't. Not until I know who that skeleton man was and what he was doing here and why he knocked me out like that. Look, I can understand you're not wanting to call the police, but somebody should investigate. And since playing detective is kind of a hobby with me...
No offense, but are you sure you didn't just pass out from the heat and humidity or something and dream that you saw the skeleton dude?
I'm positive.
Okay, look around all you want. But I should probably warn you, Uncle Bruno was into exotic pets. Didn't believe in cages, so he gave him the run of the place. And just because he's dead doesn't mean they are. So if you're gonna go poking around, be careful.